Hello and welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted to be joined on the line now by CEO Brusk Korkmaz and CFO Paul Wheatcroft from Hercules Site Services. A very warm welcome to you both. And I'm going to start with you, Paul. Could you start by talking us through your full year update, please?
Sure. Thanks, Tom. Yeah, I mean, 2022 has been a great year for Hercules Site Services. The growth that we planned since 2019 is continuing apace. In fact, we've seen a 51% increase in revenue, which has taken us to £49.5 million in 2022. And this growth has been achieved across all areas of the business. In fact, it's the second successive year that we've managed to achieve over 50% growth. Gross profit came in at a 44% increase at £9.8 million. I think an adjusted EBITDA was at £2.3 million. Now, this continued investment in the business has continued as we prepare for more growth in the future. And this enabled us to achieve a pre-tax profit before exceptional and non-recurring items of just over £0.6 million. So a great year and more great years to come, we hope.
Thanks, Paul. That is the financial side covered off very nicely. Turning to you now, Brusk, what about on the operational side?
Thank you, Tom. Like Paul said, it was a great year for us. We completed our listing on AIM on 4th February 2022, raising £4 million gross for the company. And as mentioned, unlocking the business's great growth potential by having access to the public markets. One of our key achievements for the year has been the successful ramp up of our labor supply to HS2 Northern Section. And we also won new contracts outside HS2 as well. There has also been rapid increase in our suction excavator hire business. Hercules owns 20 vehicles currently, and there will be another 10 suction excavators will be delivered by March this year. So it is going really well. We have also seen organic growth achieved in civil projects division with an 18% increase in new clients during the period.
Lovely. So how important, Brusk, is the digital side of the business?
It is really important for us. Our in-house developed software has been critical in helping us to achieve some major labor supply projects, and it has provided us with strong reputation as innovators in the industry. In addition, our digital tools have created efficiencies within our business. Our in-house developed apps helped us to find local workers for local projects, which has differentiated us from our competitors.
Thanks, Brusk. Now, turning back to you, Paul, a successful year for the company. So can you explain your dividend policy?
Sure. At the time of the IPO, we made it clear that we intended to follow a progressive dividend policy. And that's what we're doing. The company's board is proposing a final dividend of 1.12 pence per share. Together with the interim dividend paid last August, that takes the dividend payout to 1.72 pence per share for the year, ahead of the 1.7 pence per share paid in the previous year. The company's major shareholder, Hercules Real Estate Limited, which owns 71.7% of the shares, has again, the second successive year, waived its entitlement to this payment. The dividend will be paid on the 24th of March 2023 to shareholders on the register at the close of business on the 24th of February. The shares will then go ex-dividend on the 23rd of February.
Thanks, Paul. And just one final question from me for you, Brusk. What is it that you think people can expect from the company in 2023?
Thank you, Tom. We are delighted with how the company has continued to grow since our IPO in February last year. We believe that we are going to grow significantly this year also. The UK infrastructure sector is continuing to grow with UK government's strong commitments to deliver significant investment in our rail infrastructure. As you might remember, our Chancellor Jeremy Hunt also announced in December about the recent banking reforms for potentially unlocking billions of pounds of funding for the UK's infrastructure sector. As you can see from the results, Hercules is ideally placed to benefit from the positive market conditions, and we have invested in our business during the period to prepare for continued growth for the months and years ahead.
CEO Brusk Korkmaz and CFO Paul Wheatcroft, thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you, Tom.